In this video, we'll be giving a general overview of the Drive Audit section of GAT+. We'll start off in the Files area. Here you will get a top-level view of how your organization uses Google Drive. First, you will notice this table with separate colors. This is what we call the Exposure Summary table. It represents all the files in your drive. You can view the total number of files and folders at the top. Each color represents a different level of exposure. Red indicates files that are at high risk. Yellow indicates low risk. Green indicates shared drive files. And white indicates private, orphaned, and trashed files. Clicking any of these values will display the files belonging to that category. To the right, there is another table that categorizes your files by type. Please note, if you apply a filter in this section, you will have to click Show Stats for the current filter. This will update the table based on the filter you've applied. In this example, I'll select the Create Filter button and search for files that are being shared out by a specific user. Here we can see the file, along with the details such as their owner, contributors, viewers, and so on. To remove a contributor or viewer, you can select the small drop-down arrow and click to remove the permission. Another way to take action on multiple files is to select the files using the boxes on the left. To select every file in your search, check the top box. You can then use the File Operations button to apply an action. Please note, file management, ownership change, and add replace selected file copy require GAT Unlock. To learn more about Unlock, please click the link labeled GAT Unlock Help. Now we'll move on to the File Content Search tab. In this area, you can search in real time through a user, group, or OU's drive to find files with the help of search operators. For example, if I search for private and confidential from a specific user with full text only enabled, then I would be returned any file that has the exact sentence private and confidential from this user. Here we have our result. You can view extra search operators by selecting the drop-down arrow and clicking search tips. Next, we'll check the files deleted section. In this area, you can view the different files that have been trashed or deleted in your domain's drive. Using filters, you can also search for a specific file to see when it was deleted. Next, we have the Shared Drives tab. In this area, you can view every shared drive on your domain. Like the previous areas, you can view the permissions of the drives as well as remove contributors, viewers, or commenters using the drop-down arrow. If you select a drive by checking its box, you can then use the Share Drive Operations button to manage the access permissions as well as the drive settings. Moving on to the Events tab, this area showcases all the different events that have occurred on your drive. Like the previous areas, you can view the user who did the event and the details of when the event occurred. For example, I can create a filter looking for download events. I will be shown all the files that were downloaded by a user in my domain, including the file name, when the file was downloaded, and more. The geolocated IPs can show a generalization of where the IP address was located when the event occurred. In the Folders Tree area, you can view every single personal and shared drive as well as external folders. By clicking the plus button next to a drive, you can expand the folder tree to view the contents. If you click a folder, you can view the files within as well as a detailed view of the folder's permissions. If you click the Files drop-down menu, you can view the file in Google Drive, show its events, and apply a permission change to it. Moving on to the External Domain section. Here you can get a quick look at the shares between your domain and external domains, and by creating filters, you can find all the shares between your domain and another specific domain. If you click the value showing the number of shared files, you will then be shown all the files that are being shared between the two domains. The Domain Connection Graph tab is similar to external domains, but it shows its information by mapping it out. The blue dot is your domain. The red dots are external domains. The dots towards the left side are older shares, while the dots towards the right are newer shares. The size of the dots corresponds to the number of shares between the domains. The bigger the dots, the more shares are taking place. Selecting a dot will show the connections between the two domains. At the top, you can adjust the date ranges for more accurate results. Finally, we have external users. Here you can get an overview of all the files being shared to an external user and vice versa. You can use filters here to find shares between specific users and your domain. By clicking a value, you'll be shown the files. If you enjoyed this GAT Labs video, please like and subscribe and ring the bell for regular updates. You can also get a free 15-day trial of GAT Plus by following the link in the description.